What's up, guys? Welcome back to Keto Rewind. I'm Jess, and today's video is a what I ate in a day on another eat day. As a lot of people know who have been following me lately, I've been doing alternate day fasting, and people are curious what I eat on those eat days. And I think it's pretty obvious on the fasting days, I'm doing clear liquids like water, unsweetened tea or herbal tea, coffee, black coffee, and I do make an exception for my collagen. I put collagen in my black coffee as well, and in my afternoon cup of coffee, that is. And then also like sparkling waters, and just regular water. So that's what I drink on my fasting days. And I'm testing the Perfect Keto base for fasting. So I want to give you a whole nother, like, more time to test that before I give my thoughts on that. But so that's coming up. And then, so anyway, so that when it comes to an eat day, Mother's Day weekend fell this year on an eat day. I mean, a fasting day. So today's Friday, tomorrow Saturday was supposed to be a eat day. So I'm going to just switch this weekend around and do an extended fast, like a 64-hour fast. And so I am fasting right now. I stopped eating yesterday at 7:30 p.m. So I'm gonna fast all day today. I'm gonna fast all day Saturday, and then Sunday, Mother's Day, is an eat day, and I'm gonna break that fast around 11. So I don't know exactly what the hour count is, but it will be above 60. So if anybody's curious what I'm doing or how I'm handling that, it's just one little tweak. And plus, I like to do one extended fast a month. So typically a 60-hour fast is an extended fast, in my opinion. So, and then I like to do that just to get the maximum benefits from autophagy. So that's my plan for this weekend. If anyone wants to join me and do that with you, I will give you an update how that went on my, what is that, week 65's weigh-in coming up on Monday. So anyways, to all the moms out there, grandmoms, stepmoms, dads that are moms, playing the mom role as well, happy Mother's Day. It's a tough one this year. Happy Mother's Day. And don't forget to take care of yourself. Okay, so I'm going to show you what I am eating, or I should say what I ate yesterday. I'm fasting right now, but I have to film it for you, so obviously I can't post it the same day. So I will show you what I ate yesterday on my last eat day, and yeah, I'll meet you right back here. Okay, so my lunch, I'm breaking my 40-hour fast with leftovers. It's a fried egg that has, that's been like lots of pepper cooked in butter, and then my pepper, the red bell pepper, is actually a recycled recipe that we made some keto goulash. So a way to reinvent a recipe that you want to just make it something fresh for a leftover, we threw the goulash in a bell pepper and baked it in the oven. And yeah, so that was a just experiment, and that worked out really good. I'll post a link down below or in the cards of the keto goulash that I make. It's just basically zucchini, cabbage, ground beef, a little bit of sauce, and some cheese on the top. So it was a really delicious lunch to break a fast with. but for added protein, that's why I did the one extra fried egg. So next, I'm going to move on to a snack. Flackers. I've been making these. Do you want to see a recipe on how to make these? They're made out of flax seeds. They're delicious, and it gives you that crunch. And here's dinner. We're going to do roasted kale with meatloaf. And some side of okra. So I like to buy my kale already on the stem, so it's just cheaper and easier that way, and I will show you how to like clean it. I will pull the kale off of the stem, leaving that big hard backbone down. Like, we don't, that one's yucky, so I like to pull the leaves off of that and debone it, if you will. So there's the finished product, and I'm going to put it in a bath of water with white vinegar, and that's just going to set for like 5-10 minutes ish. Let that disinfect, get everything all clean. And meanwhile, we're going to prep our pans with avocado oil. And I'm going to do 2 meatloafs, 2 pounds of ground pork, and 2 pounds of ground beef. So for a total of 4 pounds of meat, You can do this with ground turkey. You don't need to use the exact meats, but I'm gonna sprinkle some garlic powder and some onion powder. I like to do that because it makes the texture better for my kids. They like to eat it with no like chunks of onion or anything in it. So it's just a hack for to get the kids to eat it. So and then Italian seasoning, about a 1 to 2 tablespoons. We like lots of spice in our meatloaf. So, but do it to your taste. You can adjust it. And then that's about a 1/3 cup left of grated Parmesan cheese. And then also you cannot forget the almond flour. That makes it really good. So I did about 1/2 cup of almond flour, super fine almond flour that is. And then last but not least, salt and pepper to taste. I like to do a nice full 3-finger pinch of pepper. I can't do too much because the kids, you know. and then I'll do about 3 separate 3-finger pinches of pink salt. I don't know how much it is. I don't normally measure spices. I'm just one of those cooks. but about whatever, however much a 3-finger pinch would be, I did 3 of those. So, but salt it to your taste. And that was pink salt, by the way. And then I find the best way to mix this is to just use your hands. Oh, I forgot eggs. I had some egg yolks left over from something else that we made. So there's 3 egg yolks plus 1 full egg. I typically do whole eggs when I do this. So, I just didn't want to waste some eggs and, you know, I was just an experiment. So the egg yolks actually worked fine, but I typically just use regular eggs altogether. But get your hands in there and get everything all mixed and incorporated. And we're going to make this go really fast here. but I'm essentially going to get 2 loaves out of this. And I've already prepped my pan with avocado spray oil. And then once this is all has all come together, and you can really smell how it should smell. It should smell like meatloaf. So yeah, but anyways, I'm going to divide that into 2 loaves, about 2 pounds of meat per loaf. And then you're going to just take your pans. My pans have been like, they're hand-me-downs. They're like 30 years old. so don't judge my pans. They are legit pans. So pop those in the oven at 375 for about 35 minutes until it's done. Look at the water after I drained the kale. I just have it on a paper towel to dry it off. And then I will show you what I'm going to season it with. So avocado oil is my go-to oil for roasting vegetables. You probably need maybe 2 tablespoons tops. I'm doing 2 trays of kale just because I don't like to crowd the pan. So each of these trays total... I will use, for each of them, I'll use 2 tablespoons of avocado oil, salt and pepper on both of them. Sometimes I'll add garlic powder on there too, but just like the meatloaf, use those hands. I mean, it's my freaking food and it's going to get cooked. I was sure to pick my butt first though. Totally kidding. Anyways, I made a homemade ketchup, keto ketchup. I'll post that link to the recipe down below. If you haven't been making your own keto ketchup, you have been missing out. It's delicious and so easy to make. There's a finished product of the roasted kale. You can see how much it cooks down when it's in the oven roasting. And it should have a little bit of a brown color on it. And there's some okra. Just dice up some okra, throw in a can of diced tomatoes and some salt, pepper. And yeah, that's a really easy dish to make. And there's the finished product. I believe it's 165. You need the center to be. I put Parmesan cheese on the kale. There's the okra. Just enough. You know, I just love okra. I'm in the South, so we like okra here. And there's 6 ounces of finished meatloaf. And that was my dinner. I'm going to top this with just a chocolate chip cookie for dessert. Okay, well, I hope you enjoyed this video. I have not been tracking my macros since I've been doing alternate day fasting, but I will mention I've been going on a 5-mile walk every night after dinner. So as soon as dishes are done, my husband and I just lace up the shoes, get a glass of water, and then go walk 5 miles. So this week I've already racked up 30 miles, but I just found that I feel so good after I have dinner and then I go for a walk. I just enjoy it. And so that's what we've been doing after that. So I have not been tracking food, in the macro calculator, but I have been alternate day fasting and walking 30 miles so far this week, roughly 5 miles a day. So we'll see what that's done. If, you know, when it comes to the weigh-in for week 65, but I just wanted to mention that I'm trying to learn how to enjoy food, eat intuitively so I don't have to track everything. But like I said, when I started my journey, I did track all of my macros. I learned what proper serving sizes are. I learned how much food, that amount of food should look like on a plate so that I could get to this point to wean myself off of the tedious tracking. Even though the tracking, I swear by the tracking, I swear by it, but I'm saying I can't track forever. I have to learn, and I'm at that point now where I can take that step. So anyways, I hope you enjoyed this video. All the recipe links will be down below, and let me know if you want me to show you how to make those keto crackers that are made out of flax seeds. So super easy recipe. But anyways, I'm Jess. Have a great weekend. Happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there, and I'll see you at the next video. Bye-bye!